First thing, I was captivated by the fact that this was written and directed by a woman, which is a big issue for us here, and a Mexican woman. And that secondly, and then I read the script and I thought it showed there's that theme, isn't there, in life? How far are you prepared to go to save someone you love? You know, we face this all the time with our loved ones and our parents, and we think to ourselves, my God, would I have saved that person? So that's the theme, and particularly with family, I think. We don't know, but I suspect we'd go all the way. I know I would. I've got children, grandchildren. I can't imagine not going all the way to save them. So that's the overall thing, and I love that theme, because it tests us the whole time, you know. At what stage do we throw our principles out the door, you know, and we face this in America a lot at present politically, but how do we throw our principles out the door? Or do we stick to them and risk our lives? That's the theme, and it's a very important one. That whole idea of there are these portals around the world that which contain an energy that can create great things or bad things, and the Bermuda Triangle, the pyramids, and of course the zone of silence in Mexico, not the only ones, but things happen there and no one knows why. What is it that draws comets to this place as against somewhere 70 miles away, or why do aeroplanes lose their controls, or both? We're starting to get there, but it's to do with the wonderful magnetic qualities of the Earth, to be honest with you, but it still feels awfully mysterious. To do with our ability to shift backwards and forwards between time, I don't perceive that as such a problem as it sounds, because we live in a world where we know now about alternative universes. We know this. We know that within our minds we can create universes. Our mind is an extraordinary thing. I can go anywhere I like if I put my mind to it, you know. So it's very much in the realm. It's not taking my physical body and going somewhere. It's in here. Been a lot of science fiction written about that. I actually don't have a problem believing that at all. I know this experience well. I have children, I have grandchildren, and at times the grandchildren live with me. So I do know this one pretty well. So it wasn't a challenge for me. And I've got my two daughters. I mean, Melina's around about the right age. And she's also a fantastic lady, so we got on just like she was a daughter. I didn't have a problem with that father, particularly under the circumstances in the film. That grandfather had no alternative but to do what he did. He was driven by this thing. How far will you go to save a loved one? Well, we'll find out. We find out in this film. In television, I've worked with still too few, but now there's a growing number of excellent female directors. I don't have any issue at all. In fact, sometimes I think the communication is better between a man and a woman. I think so. When I say a woman director, I'm only saying that in terms of the current political movements, you know, I should say that director, not the female director. But also the fact that I was offered it with the Mexican company, with the Mexican writer, director, producers, and that kind of excited me a lot, because I actually love Mexico. And I don't know, all of those things added up, and the story was interesting as well. So lots of contributing factors. It was crazy trying to get it done, because I was whipping between jobs, and I just finished in Canada the day before, and it was crazy, but it was worth it.